What a great pedal. This is the Dark Sun Digital Delay and Reverb by Seymour Duncan. It's a collaboration, a project between Mark Holcomb from Periphery and their tech engineer Riley, who I think has done an amazing job. It's quite a complex pedal, but it's easy to use and it inspires creativity, which is something that Mark said. I noticed that Mark said in his own video, and it's true. It's been sitting on my desk for, gosh, 4 or 5 days, not because it's challenging, but because it's just so much fun to play with, and every time I turn it on, I find some new crazy sound that inspires me to keep going. This is an SE, a PRS SE Mark Holcomb signature, so I'm kind of keeping it in the family today, and I'm using a PRS Archon amp model in the XFX 3 sitting over there running firmware 16, or the latest beta of firmware 16. And one day I'll put a real Archon in here. Hello, Ray. I think we should put one in, don't you? Yes. Because they're great amps. Anyway, Dark Sun, reverb and delay. 50 milliseconds of delay up to 5 seconds. And you can divide those delays between quarter notes, eighth triplets, eighths triplets, and then patterns. You've got reverse delay. You've got ping-pong delay, which is stereo to and fro. And you've got reverse ping-pong as well. Over here, in the routing options, you can have your delay before your reverb, or your reverb before your delay, delay on one side, reverb on the other in parallel, and vice versa. The reverb itself is a hall reverb. So let's start with a good old quarter note delay. I'll go back to the clean tone. Turning him on here. So you can hear a little bit of reverb mixed in with that as well. I can use the reverb mix to pull that right out. Dynamic expression is basically a ducker. So the more I turn this little green knob up, the more it's going to duck before it brings in that delay. Turning it all the way anti-clockwise, it'll just be there when I play. Some of these different modes, reverse pong. Ping pong. If you want to, you can use the delay mix knob over here to mix out your entire dry signal, which will be a bit more fun if you're using something like the reverse setting here. Or the reverse pong. Get the idea? It's a lot of fun. There's a little trails knob here that will let you manually turn on trails, turn on or off trails rather, when you hit the bypass knob, and that'll keep them going for as long as this feedback knob is set. Tap presets. Well, you can tap tempo. The readout will give you either beats per minute or milliseconds, and as I said, it runs from 50 milliseconds up to 5 seconds, quite long. If you hold it, you can cycle through A, B, C, or D, depending on which bank you've dialed up. If you want another bank, hit the little bank switch over here. Over here is your EQ section. You've got low pass filter, which will basically tame the top end. So if you want something closer to an analog delay, that's where you would head to. High pass filter, which tames the bottom end. And then a saturation switch, which brings in a little bit of gain onto the wet signal. Uh, Excellent, apparently, if you're running distortion sounds, because it's going to help you to cut through a little better, and we'll do that in a moment. Let's turn this delay mix down, have a listen to the reverb, which is a hall reverb. So I've got a mix knob for it here, and then I've got the room size. As I said, I've got a routing knob over here, so if I want parallel, say, reverb on that side or that side, I can do that. Or I can have delay before reverb, or reverb after delay. Feedback will go from one feedback, or one repeat rather. One repeat. All the way to infinity. There are 32 banks of four presets, 128 presets, which you can control with MIDI. In fact, you can control all of the controls with MIDI, because there's a MIDI in and there's a MIDI out. It is true stereo, as you've heard, because we've just been running the ping-pong. Over here, you've got depth control and rate control and blend for the modulation. So I'm just going to back this feedback off a little bit and turn the reverb down. Right. So you can get some nice chorusy sounds. Underneath them is the blend control, which lets you blend between D and R, or delay and reverb. That applies modulation to only delay, or modulation just to reverb, or a mixture of both, right in the middle there. Now, of course, Mark is primarily a metal player, though he does do a lot of really cool ambient stuff as well, so it's got to work in that situation, and I think it does. And as you can see, it's a lot of fun. You can do all sorts of crazy wild noises with it. So much possibility. It's industrially built. It looks industrial. It's not a fancy pedal. It's made to work, you know, in a live situation, and the MIDI integration is, you know, something else. I really like the Dark Sun. I'm going to explore it more. I recorded some stuff last night. Maybe I'll mix it in with this video. Yeah, if you're looking for a great sounding, unique sounding actually, stereo delay and reverb with infinite possibility, I highly recommend you have a look at Seymour Duncan's Dark Sun. See ya.